In Chicago. I don't know if you want to lay it out a little
Well,
bit.
it's the special prosecutor has ruled that Burgess, Don Burgess, John Burgess,
Bird.
and the detectives under his rule had falsely convicted or forced over 100 suspects to confess to crimes that they didn't commit. And 10 of those 100 plus on you know, on death row. So it's they just coerced people and tortured them to make confessions to crimes that they didn't commit.
Yeah.
And he's been indicted in 1990. But he was in 1993, Burgess was fired, you know, and but he was doing this since 1972.
Yeah.
Since 1972 to 1991. And I don't know what happened, but maybe they took him off cases or something. And in 1993, you know, he was fired. And in 2006, they started an investigation. And then in 2008, he was indicted.
Yeah,
you know,
John Burge is actually, he's a former Vietnam vet and also a former Chicago lieutenant. And like as you said, he, you know, he served for a pretty long time from 1970 until 1993. And he was dismissed. But what's unfortunate is that some of the people who were supposedly in, you know, allegedly in cahoots with him, you know, some of the officers that are alleged to have been involved in these incidents were reinstated. So while he was dismissed and retired to Florida with his pension, these other officers were put back on the job. And does that sound familiar?
Oh, listen, I mean, look at, you know, I mean, it's just a story that constantly replays over and over and over again. And, you know, it seems that the person, one of the persons that was given a long sentence, he believed in the justice system. You know, and I think that's a mistake a lot of people make. I think that's something that we all want to believe in something, you know. And then when you get caught up within the justice system, you want to feel that it's fair and, you know, like what Lady Justice has that blindfold on, you know. But the, like they say, the blindfold is direct, you know, diagonally across her face, and it's one eye that's peeping, you know, because it's the same thing over and over and over again, you know. It's come down to my basic definition of what justice is, because again, that's what everybody wants when we go through this criminal justice system. And my definition now is might makes right.
Well, one of the things we definitely need to mention is that all of the people who were allegedly tortured were black. All African-American men, you know, during this time, and that the nature of the torture was electric shock to the hands, legs, genitals, other areas, and a plastic bag over their head.
Right.
So, you know, it's interesting that a former Vietnam vet would have been, you know, is alleged to have employed torture techniques that you would think would be, you know, would occur during wartime, and this is happening in the city, you know, in the state of Chicago, in Chicago, Illinois.
Well, I mean, and even, but again, it's not only just, you know, the urban centers, or it's not just in Chicago. I mean, it's all over. You know, we've always, look at Sean Bell. I mean, you know, I mean, it's just a bad situation, and it's always the same end. You know, the cops, this is the first time that the cop has been indicted. You know, I don't know if he's going to be convicted of the crime, because what, he's been indicted on perjury and obstruction of justice, I think. Now,
And the reason, I just want to mention, the reason for that is because the statute of limitations has expired on a lot of these cases.
On the torture.
On the torture.
But I think that the seminal or the most important aspect of that whole case is that they had a special prosecutor.
It's the unfortunate thing about this case, because although these people were some of the people were paroled, their convictions were upheld. So they still have that black mark, and that's one of the things that the defense attorney is trying to use in his, you know, in defense of Burge, by saying, well, look, the convictions still stand, you know, and trying to make it look like it wasn't as bad as it was. But some of these torture cases were heinous. I mean, he's known to have used a cattle prod, an electric shock wand, you know, things of, you know, again, the plastic bag over the head. This is along the lines of what we've discussed on the show many times about waterboarding. And, it's on that level where you're basically putting somebody in the, to the point where they're willing to confess to anything just to get you to stop.
Well, I think one incident where, I think his name was Howard, he was getting slapped around and he got knocked out. And, he woke up because he was getting slapped around again.
Yeah.
And he said that, you know, and so he was really being recalcitrant and really wasn't going to, you know, confess to anything. And they took him outside, I think, and they told him, well, go ahead and run. You know, they told him to run because they wanted to shoot him. So these people, to me, are like terrorists.
Yeah.
You know, I'm talking about the police. They're running roughshod and doing these kinds of things on citizens of the United States. I mean, it's horrendous that they would do it to anybody. But again, these people are pathological. You know, they have to be sick to do these things to people, you know, with cattle prods. And those are for animals.
Yeah.
You know, I mean, so what type of people are we hiring and putting, you know, in the police force? Because was he like this before? I mean, this, and we're just talking about this situation, but there are other, you know, you just, and nowadays, look at the, Rodney King, you know, I mean, we just see all of these videos of people getting shot, usually people of color. I really haven't seen any white person, well, and let alone a black cop shooting anybody white or any, I've never seen that. So it's the same scenario over and over and over again. And after a while, we have to wake up and say, come on now, you know, we got to do something else.
Yeah.
You know?
And you know, it's a travesty of justice, no matter how you look at it. But, you know, whether or not you're dealing with criminals or innocent individuals, torture is torture and it shouldn't
That's
be
right.
allowed.
Exactly.
I just want to quickly mention a case that's surrounding this as well. A gentleman by the name of Andrew Wilson, he's dead now, mm-hmm. you know, but he was in jail for killing two police officers, and he was convicted of killing two police officers. Mm-hmm. His name is very pertinent to this case because normally the rules of evidence in court is that you can't use any information unless the prosecutor or the defense attorney, I should say, can actually cross-examine the witness. Mm-hmm. This gentleman is dead, but he, during the time that this case first started, he had actually, you know, he was convicted of killing these two police officers, but they did have a civil case over him being tortured. So the first case resulted in a mistrial, and the second case they actually went through. He actually won the case,
mm-hmm.
but again, the point I'm trying to bring up is that even though you have someone who committed a heinous crime himself, because he was actually alleged to have done a home invasion, you know, he dressed as a postal worker and, you know, beat up or, you know, a middle-aged woman, you know, he actually convicted, you know, had done armed robberies, things mm-hmm. of that nature. So, you know, he was a career criminal.
Mm-hmm.
But he was arrested by this gang, including Burge, tortured.
Mm-hmm.
So, again, we have that situation where it doesn't matter if you're innocent or you're guilty.
Mm-hmm.
We are expecting more out of the police department.